In this lesson, we will learn how to place tags. Tags are labels that we use to organize a project better. In earlier versions of SketchUp, you may encounter tags as layers. The tags options can be found in the default tray window, under the Tags tab. If this tab does not appear in your default tray window, right-click on the top of the window and select Manage Trays. From the Manage Trays window, select the default tray and activate the Tags dialog. Since, in my case, this dialog is already activated, I will simply close this window. Back in the drawing area, you can see various objects of different shapes. More specifically, there are three circles, three rectangles, and two arcs. With tags, we will divide these objects into three categories. First, I need to create the tags, so I will expand the Tags tab from the default tray on the right. In this dialog, we can see and edit all the tags of the scene. By default, there is always one tag, which is called untagged. So, if we don't create another tag, this is where all the objects we create are placed. In this example, I will create three tags, one for the circles, one for the rectangles, and one for the arcs. To add a tag, I will click on the plus icon, and in the active field, I will type the name of the new tag. I will name this tag circles and press enter. I will add another tag by clicking on the plus icon again. This time, I will type the name rectangles, and I will press enter. Finally, I will create one more tag and name it arcs. The next step is to place the objects of the scene in the appropriate tags. First, I will select all the circles. Then, from the Entity Info tab, I will expand the tag drop-down menu, and I will select the circles tag. Now, if I select the surface of one of the circles, I can see that it has indeed been moved to the circles tag. At this point, I will place the remaining items in the corresponding tags. So, I will select the three rectangles, and in the same way, I will move them to the rectangles tag. Finally, I will select the two arcs and move them to the arcs tag. When I finish placing all the items in the corresponding tags, I will return to the Tags tab to change the settings for the labels. By clicking on the eye icon, which is located on the left of each tag's name, you can hide or show the items in that particular tag. The name column displays the names of the tags, and you can change the name of any tag by double-clicking on it. The only name you cannot change is the untagged tag, which is the default tag. By clicking on the color icon, the Edit Material window appears, and you can change the color of the current tag. We will elaborate on placing materials on an object in the following lessons. You can choose the outlines type from the dashes column. For example, you can change the continuous lines to dashed ones. Finally, the pencil icon shows which tag is current. When a tag is set as the current tag, anything we are going to draw is automatically placed in this tag. I will make the circles tag the current tag, and then I will create a random circle. I will deactivate the circle tool, and then I will select the circle I just created. Notice that it has been placed in the circles tag. Now, I should mention that if you want to delete a tag, you can simply select it and click on the Delete Tag icon. When we delete a tag, the objects that were placed in it are automatically moved to the untagged tag. If you delete the current tag, SketchUp will display a message asking us what we want to do with the objects in this tag. We can either move contents to the default tag, namely untagged, or delete the contents along with the tag. In this example, I will select the first option, Move Contents to Default Tag, and click OK. With this option, the objects that were in the current tag were moved to untagged. To sum up, tags are a very useful way to organize your projects and manage the objects in a scene.